Hello dear students, welcome to the class. So today I am going to teach you the Maurin administration. In the previous class I taught you about the sources of the Maurin empire, like literary sources, archaeological sources, pillars, stupas and all that. So today I'll teach you the administrative structure of the Maurin empire during the period of Chandragupta Maurya, Ashoka, and even about Bindusara. Mostly we'll be discussing about the administrative feature of the Maurya Empire in connection with Chandragupta Maurya's rule and Ashoka's rule. So let's jump into the PC. So let's start Maurya administration. So we derive a lot of information regarding the Maurya administration from Chanakya's Arthashastra. Chanakya, the prime minister in the court, advised Chandragupta Maurya in matters of administration. So Chanakya's Arthashastra throws much light on the administration of the Maurya empire. So the entire structure of the Maurya administration was headed by the central government. The king was the supreme source of all powers and was center of all authorities, judiciary and administration. In the highly centralized administration, king used to select ministers, high officials, and established a well-planned system of supervision and inspection. So on top of the administration was the king. So king was the supreme source of all powers. All the powers were centralized in the hands of the king. So it was a centralized system of a Mauryan administration. Now, the king was assisted by Mantri Parishad, also known as Council of Ministers. Today also, you know, we have the Prime Minister, and the Council of Ministers. So Council of Ministers are the one to aid and advise the Prime Minister. Same way, Mantri Parishad. King was assisted by his Council of Ministers, known as Mantri Parishad, which was headed by Mantri Parishad Adhyaksh. Mantri Parishad Adhyaksh. So mantris were there and the mantris were headed by Mantri Parishad Adhyaksh. Okay, now let us now try to understand different ministers. Some of these departments and their adhyaksh are listed below. Like account general was known as Akhal Padhyaksh. Okay, royal treasury Sannidhata. Then treasury of superintendent was known as Kostagar. The mine superintendent was known as Akar Adhyaksh. Gold superintendent was known as Suvarna Adhyaksh. Okay, then again similar way, commerce superintendent was known as Panya Adhyaksh. Then Kupaya Adhyaksh. Then Lavana Adhyaksh. Then Ayudhgar Adhyaksh. Then Pautva Adhyaksha, that looks after weight and measurement. Then textile and spinning and weaving ministry was known as Sutra Adhyaksha. Agriculture ministry was known as Sita Adhyaksha. Exercise ministry was known as Sura Adhyaksha. Then shipping and maritime was known as Nav Adhyaksha. Okay, then government documents were looked after by ministry known as Mudra Adhyaksha. Ports, Patana Adhyaksh, Mint, Laksha Adhyaksh, then trade routes, Samastha. So this were the number of ministers who were in charge of different ministries. They look after different ministries and help the king to discharge its duties properly. Then now let us discuss about the provincial government. So provincial government, you can see over here, chart is mentioned over there. So altogether, five provinces were there. Central province was Magad. On the eastern side, Tosila was there and Kalinga was there. On the western side, Avantipatha was there, Ujjain was there. Then on the north, Uttarpath, northern side, Takshila was there. On the southern side, that is in Dakshinpath, Suvarnagiri was there. So you can see here, northern province, Uttarpath, was having its capital at Takshila. So Takshila was the capital of Uttarpath. Then again, Suvarnagiri was the capital of Dakshinpad, that is southern province. Then Ujjain was the capital of western province. Then Tosila, that is near Kalinga, Tosila was the capital. Okay, that means eastern province capital was Tosila, which was near Kalinga. Then the capital, that is a central province, Magath was a central province, and the capital of the entire kingdom, Magath was the capital of the entire province. Okay, then provinces were administered by either a prince or a member of the royal family, which was the viceroy of the king. All those provinces were headed by or looked after by the prince. They belong to the royal family. Okay, then next, district administration. Now king, then council of ministers we discuss, then now we'll discuss about the district administration. So each district was administered by three officers. Okay, they were known as Pradyaksha, Rajuka, Yukta. So now Pradyaksha was a senior and Rajuka was a subordinate. Pradyaksha was supported by or subordinate by Rajuka. Yukta was subordinate to both of them. So Pradyaksha, Rajuka, Yukta. So Pradyaksha was subordinate by Rajuka and Yukta subordinated both Pradyaksha and Rajuka. So Yukta was subordinate to both of them. It was the duty of Pradyaksha to tour the kingdom every 5 years and collect details of the administration. So entire administrative details were collected by Pradyaksha every after 5 years. That was a good thing. Okay. And so village administration. Village was the smallest unit of polity and it was called Gram. The head of Gram was Gramika. The Gramika was not a paid employee of the government but was elected by the village people. The 10 villages were collectively headed by Gopa and 100 villages were collectively headed by Satnaka. Okay, Gramika is open panchayat solved most disputes. Gramika in open panchayat solved most of the disputes. Okay, so once again, 10 villages were collectively headed by Gopa and 100 villages were collectively headed by Stana. Okay, and Gramika in open panchayat solved most of the disputes. So this is all about the village. So on the top, central administration, and at the lowest level, village was the smallest unit of polity and it was called Gram. And it was looked after by Gramika. Gramika was the head of the village, but it was not paid by the government, as this Gramika was elected by the people of the village. Now next one, let us now move towards city administration or the municipal administration. So municipal or city administration of the Mauryan Empire was very well organized and very efficient in nature. So according to Indica, which was written by Megasthenes, there was municipal council of 30 members. Municipal council of 30 members, which was divided into 6 boards, each having 5 members, looking after 6 important activities in the city administration. So city administration was also very, very good. Okay, municipal council of 30 members, which was divided into 6 boards. How many boards? 6 boards, and each board was looked after by 5 members. Okay, so let us now see which all boards were there. So first committee was concerned with matters relating to industrial art. Second occupied it with the facilities to the foreigners. These are different boards. 6 boards we discussed, no? Second occupied it with the facilities to the foreigners. The third kept a register of births and deaths, both by way of census and for purpose of taxation. The fourth committee was in charge of matters of trade and commerce. Fifth committee supervised the public sale of manufactured articles. The sixth committee collected the tax on the articles sold, this being 1/10 of the purchase of the price. So this were the, we can say that the six boards were allotted with this duty. Now let us now move forward. Now espionage, that is a spy system. Espionage means spy system. The espionage system of the Mauryas was well developed. You know that today also we have IB, RAW, right? So they are the one to alert the government before anything occurs in the country. So during the Mauryan Empire also, spurious system was very, very strong and it's well developed. There were spies who informed the king about the bureaucracy and the markets. Spies who informed the king about the bureaucracy and the markets. There are two types of spies, stationary and wanderers. Okay, so that means Sansthana and Sanchari. The first one was stationary, lived in one place, and the other one wandered from place to place and collected the information and gave to the king. Okay, next one was Gudha Puraksha. Gudha Puraksha were the detectives or secret agents. So those were two types of spies. Now secret agents were also there. Okay, they were known as Gudha Purus. Okay, Gudha Purusha were detectives or secret agents. They were controlled by the Mantri. Okay, sorry, they were controlled by the Mahamatya Pasharap. Okay, they were controlled by Mahamatya Pasharap. Mahamatya Pasharap. These agents were picked from different segments of the society. There were also agents called poisonous girls. They are the agents like poisonous girls. The term is Vishankyas. Okay, Vishankyas. So they were there were also agents called Vishankyas. They were poisonous girls. Okay, very deadly girls were also there. So this is all about the Spanish system of the Mauryan Empire. Now the judicial administration. In Arthashastra, it is mentioned that civil and criminal court was called Kanthak Sodana. Okay, Megasthenes mentioned about the rarity of crimes and their thefts were unknown. That means crimes were very, very rare in the Mauryan Empire and even thefts were not known to the people. They did not know what theft was all about. People never locked their doors while going out. Just imagine, people did not lock their doors while going out. This is because of severe code. That means people had a fear that if I commit any sort of crime, then severe penalties will be given to me. So this is because of severe code. Death penalty was given even for petty crimes, for small crimes, death penalty was given. Trial by ordeal was prevalent in the administration of the Mauryan Empire. So judicial administration was very, very strict. And due to this, the people were completely disciplined and crimes were very, very rare in the Mauryan Empire. Okay, now next one, we'll discuss about military administration, army. Okay, the overall in charge of Mauryan army was commander in chief, who was immediately junior to the king. After the king, commander in chief was junior to the king. The Mauryan army included 6 lakh infantry, 30,000 cavalry, 9,000 war elephants, 1,000 chariots, and other things such as transport equipments. There was a war council which was further divided into 6 sub councils, each with 5 members, which formulated policy for infantry, cavalry, elephant forces, chariots, navy and commissariat. Navy, transport, in forces and commissariat were Mauryan innovations. So navy, transport in forces and commissariat were Mauryan innovations. Okay. So this is all about from this chapter. So thank you very much for watching it. We'll meet again in next class. Till then, take care, stay safe. Bye-bye.